Hello everyone, I am Dr. Vishal Ramesh More, consulting chest physician. I am a consultant at KEM Hospital in Pune and Sahyadri Multispeciality Hospital at near Kalyani Nagar, Nagar Road. And I practice in this Viman Nagar and Dhanuri area. Smoking and pollution, these are both the same because the smoking, it literally burns your respiratory system. It has a drastic effect on your lung conduct, means airways, which are conducting the all airways, and there are mucus regulating some factors and some cilia. Cilias are like just beating hairs in your lung airways. So your smoking and pollution damages your cilia, and there is chronic mucus production in airways. So because of which the lung functions are reduced, the physiology of the lung is reduced, you are more prone for cancer of the lung, you are more prone for accumulation of the mucus in the lungs and airways, which may be prone you for pneumonia and swine flu and other viral infections, so which are very dreadful diseases. Smoking reduces your lung age. Yes, we can calculate your lung age with a simple spirometry test, which we have to blow in the computer, and we can determine your lung functions and your lung age. And smoking drastically reduces your lung age. Average lung volume decreases by 30 ml per year. But if you are exposed to some noxious smoke, toxins and pollution, definitely it almost decreases by 60 to 70 ml per year. That is double the normal lung volume. So these are the very dreadful effects of smoking and pollution. We can do lung function test, which we call it as pulmonary function test. This test is very specific. It may pick up early lung some obstruction. It may also determine your age of the lung. Yes, you can determine age of your lung. Lungs are slight younger than you because after birth your lungs get activated and you take first breath. So since then your lungs are exposed to outer environment continuously, so we can determine your age of the lung. So one is the pulmonary function test. Second thing is bedside peak flow expiratory meter. So we can just record your flow. How is your flow in your airways, large airways, small airways? We can record that just like a thermometer, which is used for recording the temperature, or BP apparatus for recording the blood pressure. Similarly, this breathometer is a simple device which you can use at home, and this device tells you 3 days prior how is your lung function, whether it is going to deteriorate or not. Third thing is some routine blood investigation. Yes, we call it as lung profile or smoking profile or pollution profile. You have to evaluate yourself by routine complete blood count, kidney function test, serum IgE level, absolute eosinophil count. These are some basic investigation you should definitely do regularly, every yearly, to see whether your lungs are functioning properly or whether any issue with your lungs. And third thing is, yes, if you have any symptoms, and accordingly what chest physician advise you to do, chest x-ray or CT scan, that you can do definitely. Yes, definitely diet and exercise definitely improves your lung functions. First thing, diet. Diet is different from different diseases. If you have COPD, if you have asthma, if you have interstitial lung diseases, so we have to reduce your workload on your lungs. So we should plan accordingly the diet. The diet should be low in carbohydrate and rich in fat, so that you will have less production of carbon dioxide and you will feel you can breathe better if you have obstructive airway disease like COPD, bronchiectasis, asthma, whatever. So that helps in the diet. If you have interstitial lung disease, you have to have more fat and proteins in your diet, high protein, low carb diet. That helps to develop your respiratory muscles so that your breathlessness and everything is solved almost, and it definitely boosts up your immunity also. So that different chest issues have different diet. Second thing is the exercise part. So yes, exercise also helps you to maintain your lung functions, keep your lungs healthy. If yes, there are deep breathing exercises like inhaling deeply and exhaling. If patients are suffering from asthma, COPD or some smoking related lung issues, so yes, definitely they should have diaphragmatic breathing. Just you can put your hand on your abdomen, just press it in your abdomen, inhale deeply in your lungs and just pout yourself. While taking selfie, you are doing pouting, so likewise you have to do pouting and you have to exhale slowly and steadily. So that whatever trapped lung in your inside, trapped air inside your lung, whatever it is there, it will get released, and that helps a lot in COPD and asthma patient also. And second thing is, yes, the anulom vilom pranayam, that yes, definitely it has a good effect on your lung. It helps to increase your respiratory muscle strength. And yes, swimming is also a good thing for asthmatic peoples. And early morning after sunrise, 30 minute brisk walking is fantastic exercise for you. Exercise is free and you can do it on yourself. No need to join any aerobic exercise, Zumba and everything. This is free and it is, you should be close to your nature. And I would like to add, instead of too much focus on healthcare, we should develop a culture of health, because whatever lifestyle we live during your young life, means during your adolescent age, middle age, means less than 50 years of age, definitely the way we sit, the way we talk, the way we walk, the way we eat, and the, all the good and bad habits, yes, definitely that is the culture. And whatever we change, whatever the culture we will change, that will affect in your late 60s. Definitely, culture of health is very important instead of healthcare.